Now, from our high-definition studios, this is Local Edition.
Hello, and thanks for watching this Local Edition. I'm Eric Watilla. Well, the Cadillac Area Artists Association recently held their annual art fair. The event took place between July 18th and 19th. Benjamin Ari has more.
Eric, a few sprinkles of rain couldn't keep back visitors to a recent art fair held in Cadillac's downtown park.
The art festival this year has been a huge success. We got a little rain right now, but we're joking that this is part of the crowd control.
The fair brought out many diverse artists, in addition to some fun performances.
It's been a very successful day. We've had two performance venues, one in the pavilion, and then one just east of the Shea locomotive, where we've had talent going on in both places. And that's been very successful and very popular. We have a lot of people show up for that. The Create-In has been a real hit this year too. That's been expanded and it's larger than ever. We had over 100 artists show up for the art fair, and the food tents are all full, so it's been a real success.
The show has some history, and its focus has always been on the art.
This is our 40th year, and it's really, it's a very cultural center here. We not only have the visual arts, we also have a lot of music that goes along with the program, and we interact with children a lot. We have the Create-In, which is a wonderful addition to the show that's developed over the years.
With many expensive works of art on display, the economy had some effect on sales, but the artists were quick to mention that great art is something that is priceless.
Well, I'd say the turnout's fairly good this year. It's true with the economy, you get more lookers than buyers. So as an artist, it can't always be about the money. It has to be about the work and, you know, your love of it and hopefully sharing your love of it with others.
In the end, the event was considered a success by all.
They're having a great time. They really are. I've heard from a lot of folks that they've really enjoyed it this year. It was very crowded down here last night. It was a great time.
Now, organizers are already planning to hold the event again next summer. I'm Benjamin Ari for Local Edition. Now back to you, Eric.
Well, thanks, Benjamin. Coming up next on Local Edition, Walking for a Cure. We'll take a look at an annual fundraiser in Misaukee County. Stay with us.
Local Edition is your community, your events, and your first and only source for local news in high definition, bringing you the sharpest image and the clearest coverage of the news in your area. Local Edition is covering your community.
And welcome back to Local Edition. I'm Eric Watilla. Well, an event held on July 25th and 26th has a theme important to those involved.
Celebrate, remember, and fight back.
The 2008 Misaukee County Relay for Life event is being held between the 25th and 26th of July. The event is an overnight fundraiser with the goal of helping to raise funding to find a cure for cancer. While the event is a fundraiser, those involved said it's about much more than just raising money.
It's also an opportunity for the community to gather together and remember those that we've lost and celebrate those that are still with us, and to fight back against this horrible disease.
Now, the Misaukee County Relay for Life takes place from noon on July 25th until noon on July 26th. For more information, call Marsha Rakove at 839-7638. That does wrap up this Local Edition. I'm Eric Watilla. Thanks for watching.
If you have a news story you think would be of interest to the community, email us at news@local-edition.com or call 842-0188.